I have a confession. I love Google. It's a courageous company that makes magic happen. Nowhere else in the world would the session on the promise of youth start with a professor in statistics that is 72 years old. There you have it, the promise of youth. Yeah. So it's really the challenge. I had to really build myself up to do this. Now, I'm going to talk about the world. What do you know? We want to know about the world. You go to Google search, and you want to know about the world population. So many of you do like I do. You go to image directly, isn't it? Yeah? You want something for your presentation, and you write world population. And what do you get? You get the demographic graph. You increase it like this. This is some environmental site who want to recycle, and they show this fantastic thing here, which is terrifying, that world population is just growing and growing and growing like this. Huh? Millions are added, we are 7 billion now. Huh? And you say, can this really be possible? Is it like this? This may be wrong, it's just the environmentalist. I was wrong, I shouldn't have gone to image. I have to do the serious thing. I go to web search and I write world population, and what do I get? I get a little one box up there, which I can click on, and Google provide me with the graphics. And it's really true, look. The world population is just growing, 3 billion all the way up, and data from the World Bank updated April 26. Oh, this sounds serious, but how can that be? I just played Gapminder's Casino out there with Karin and Daniel, and I saw the number of children per woman going down. So how can the population go up if the number of children per woman goes down? So I go in here. What was it called? That was a statistical term. I don't remember the statistical term. So I write children per woman, world. Huh, I get another box. It's called fertility rate. I ask for children per woman and Google gives me a fertility rate. So someone inside their server is thinking. They knew that I wanted fertility rate and didn't know what it was called. So I click on this one and I see indeed the number of children per woman is falling. It used 1960 to be 5 and is all the way down to 2.5. We wanted it to go down to 2, it's down 5/6 of the way down to a stable two-child family, and yet the population is growing. Now this, Google didn't help me to understand. They gave me the information, they didn't help me to understand. And this is a next step in search to help you to understand. How would I be able to do this? And can I really trust the World Bank? They're neighbor to IMF, and these days, you know, No. I won't do that. I'll go to solid. So you go to UN statistics and you find UN population division here, United Nations, and you see number of births per year. Number of births per year from 1950. And this is on, they are not so much into graphics, you know, they are very conventional. Number of births, 1950, 97 million, it went out to 120 million, see this increasing, went up to 937 million births, 1990. And then it stopped increasing. Breaking news, the number of births per year in the world stopped growing already 20 years ago. Can you see the gap in understanding here? 20 years ago, the number of births per year stopped growing, and yet the population is growing. How come? There's place for understanding here. How could we do this? So we decided we have to make this understandable. You bring photo, you show Mexican families, Bangladesh family, Vietnamese families, 2 children per woman. Catholic, Muslim, Buddhist, doesn't matter. Religious leaders and political leaders are not in the bedroom. People make their own decisions, you know. And you have family sizes coming down. So I made a mock-up, what I wanted to show. And I use, it's a program called PowerPoint. It was very popular once. and people like me use it to make mock-ups. It's quite good to make mock-up. Here we have, 1960, we had 3 billion people in the world. 1 billion kids, 1 billion youth, 1 billion old. Take it or leave it, I made it simple. And then it increased 25 years later, one generation later, there were 5 billion. Yes, the number of children were growing. Remember, that was when the number of births increased. Every year, more and more children were born because women were getting 5, 4, 3 children per woman. And then, of course, these people grow older and came up to this famous group 60+, which I belong to. And what happens then? From 1985 onwards, look here, this is the big news. From 1985, the number of children did not grow. The number of youth increased, and they are sitting there. They are sitting there. They are out demonstrating. They want freedom. And the number of old people increased up here, and we want walking aids and pensions, isn't it? This is the two big news in the world. The number of young people are increasing in the emerging market. The number of old people are increasing in the most wealthy countries. This is more or less where we are today. And what will happen the next 25 years? Well, this is more or less where we will go. These people will grow up. That's why the population is still growing. It's not because the number of children are growing. It's because the number of children are going to live their life. What's the difference between me and those people sitting over there? Can you see the difference? It's some tragic 35, 40 years of difference. That's the time, the breaking distance of population growth. The breaking distance is what we are experiencing now. And the environmentalists go too wild about population. That's not the issue. We have to use energy in a new way. That's the issue. So this is the good news. We have youth that are capable and that may have to be made use of. So we made another mock-up, you know. And this is the one which we have here. But that's made by Daniel. Daniel, stand up. Daniel, you know Daniel from the casino, you know. What does he make? Look at, what is the difference? You see, stand up. Stand up. You see the difference? This man makes mock-up in PowerPoint. He makes it in HTML5. That's it, the difference. So now you can make quite amazing things very fast. It moved like this. And here in 1960, the world looked like this. The ones from 0 to 15, 15 to 30, 30, 45, 45, 60, my group and the even older here. There was a population pyramid-like structure. And then the world changed like this. See how clear it will come. The number of children was increasing until here. Now the lower bar stops increasing and we get an increase of young people. You see the group there. They are the one being increased. And the future will be like this. And it takes that time until the world has really, really come up. Now, I have to stop. Finish with some bubbles. Otherwise, I will not be satisfied. I have to give you some bubbles here. Look, 1963, on this axis, income per person. The bubbles are the countries, the color is the continent. $400, $4,000, $40,000. Rich countries, poor countries. Here, percent young people, this happens to be 20 to 39. And young people from 20% up to 40%. There was not more or less the same proportion in the populations of the world because the number of children per woman has been falling gradually. But look what has happened. I start the play button here and it goes on like this. And you can see what's happening is the number of young goes up, the proportion of young goes up. This is China. Then they fall down and that's where we are today. The countries in middle income, the emerging economy, they have a high proportion of young people. The poorest countries still have mainly children and they have high child mortality. Whereas these ones are falling down with less and less young people and it's becoming boring places like Sweden and Germany down there. Not funny. I can see the point. Not funny at all. So here, I put child mortality to show you the story. Child mortality, high child mortality, low child mortality, the same axis here. And then I put the play button and you will see how the world changed. It went like this. Child mortality went down and then proportion of young people peaked here. It's quite interesting, isn't it? Here down you have Germany and Sweden. Up here, who is there on top? Who is the countries today that has the highest proportion of young people? See if you've heard about them in the news. Bahrain, Iran, Libya, Tunisia. Ain't statistics fantastic? Thank you very much.